What's going on, family? I'm Scrapbook Boxing, Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuff Series. I want to continue to examine 100 years of world championship fights. Wednesday, December 10th, 1958. 4-1 underdog old mongoose Archie Moore knocks out Canadian's heavyweight Yvon Durell. 11 rounds at the Montreal Forum. And Moore was down 3 times in the first round. The referee was Jack Sharkey. He was the former heavyweight champion. And he was mob connected. Now, Archie Moore was known as the Old Mongoose. He was born December 13th, Benoit, Mississippi. 1916. Died December 9th, 1998. He was 81 or 85 years of age at the time of his death. And he would reside in San Diego, California. No one knew the true age of Archie Moore because they didn't know his true birth. But we did know his true death, December 9th, 1998. Not quite sure of his age. Had the pleasure of meeting Archie Moore several times. And I know he had a 27-year professional career, for from 1935 to 1963. He won 183 fights, 24 losses, 10 draws, and 131 knockouts. That's fascinating. Now, Moore had 8 children. They were all at his bedside. He would suffer from a heart attack. And he fought 61 times against top 10 opponents, 15 times against future Hall of Famers. Yvon Durell, known as the Fighting Fisherman. He was born October 14, 1929, at Bays Mink in Canada. Died January 6, 2007. He was 77 years of age at the time of his death, and he would reside in Maple Leaf. He would suffer from a stroke. Fought from 1948 to 1964, lost his Canadian Heavyweight Championship crown to George Shivalo. That was at the Maple Leaf Gardens. He had a total bout career, 115 fights, 90 wins, 51 knockouts, 24 losses, and 2 draws. Yvon Durell could punch. He was a fisherman by trade. Died on Christmas Day. Knocked out his teacher at the age of 14. One of 13 siblings. Now, Yvon Durell was 29 years old when he fought Archie Moore. He stood 5'9", weighed 175 pounds. He had a 70-inch reach. Had a record of 79 wins, 19 losses, 2 draws, and 42 knockouts. Archie Moore was either 41 or 42 years of age when he fought Yvon Durell. Stood 5'11", weighed 175 pounds, had a 75-inch reach, and had a record of 174 wins, 21 losses, 9 draws, and 123 knockouts. Yvon Durell would fight Floyd Patterson, Al Andrews, Tony Anthony. Archie Moore fought the who's who of boxers, such as Eddie Charles, Charlie Billy. He'd be in the ring with Rocky Marciano, Muhammad Ali, Lloyd Marshall, and everyone else in between. I want to take a look at the fight that took place Wednesday, December 10th, 1958, between Yvon Durell and Archie Moore. What a ring classic that was. Right here on the Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuff Series.
5 points to the winner of a round, a less number to the loser, an even round giving each fighter 5 points. Round number one. The referee does not involve himself in the scoring of the fight. The three judges do all the scoring. The referee does not have a vote in the fight, except, of course, that he can stop the fight and also that he can penalize a fighter for a foul. Both fighters wearing dark trunks. Archie Moore's have the gold stripe, whereas Yvon Durell is wearing the white stripe. Expert guesswork on this fight. Came to a unanimous conclusion that Durell would have to come storming in at Archie Moore early in the fight if he were to
woo!
Get him, and he just did with the right hand of the draw.
Oh my God. This is the champion. That's a champion. And that's a Hall of Fame. My God, he got up from that. And he's counterpunching. Amazing fighter was Archie Moore. Beautiful right hand thrown by Archie Moore.
Still, of course, very cognizant of the danger that lies in the Burrell fist. After that careful pacing he took in the first round, it's astonishing that he can even put on a show for Yvon Burrell, but he's doing just that. Of course, a partisan audience here in favor of the a Canadian boy. But Moore was able to fend off that punching attack of Ivan Durell. That left-hand shot of Moore's was picked off mainly on the glove of Durell. through the between round period, once again trying to take a psychological shot at Ivan Durrell, refusing to show any sign of weakness, any sign of fatigue. And a right hand shot bumped alongside the jaw of Ivan Durrell. The amazing Archie Moore, down three times in the first round, and fighting back strongly in round four, and nailed again in the fifth round for a six count, but by the time that round ended, he was giving out as much as he was receiving. Now we're in the sixth round, a scheduled 15 rounder for the light heavyweight championship of the world. Archie Moore, tonight up against what is amounting to, by far, the toughest test of his light heavyweight reign. Bloody the nose of Ivan Durrell.
Oh, Ivan Durrell is hurt. Oh, beautiful combinations by Archie Moore. Durrell is hurt again. Beautiful. He's hurt again. Moore's going to open up and take him out. Moore just spun him around. Moore just got caught with a left hook.
Big right hand that almost gave him the light heavyweight championship in the first and sixth rounds when he had Archie on the deck.
Oh, good body punch thrown by Ivan Durrell. Moore opens up with a beautiful combination. Oh, good right hand. Oh. My God, what a combination that was. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, good punch by Durrell. Moore opens up. He's about to take out Durrell. Durrell can't take it. This fight's over. Oh my God, what a beautiful punch thrown by Archie Moore. That's it. Fight's over. Great fight. One of the greatest fights in boxing history. Von Durrell, Archie Moore. 11th round knockout.
Archie Moore down in the first round, in the fifth round, I should say, for a six count. The turning point of this fight came in the seventh when he dropped Durrell for a three, and now this fight has ended in the 11th round. Archie, when you came into that ring in that beautiful sequin robe, I thought to myself, he looks like Superman. Well, after seeing you fight here this evening, I think you are.
Well, thank you very much. I enjoyed the fight so very much, and Von Durrell is a much better opponent than the people who ran him. And I can see why that he had a lot of those fellas down.
I would say you could see why. Wow. How much do you remember the first round?
The first round, I can remember, only thing I remember are the knockdowns, but I remember something kept coming to get up, get up. And I said, well, this can't be me. And so I had to get up. I said, well, if there's no free round knockdown mandatory. So I kept getting up, and I figured, well, I'd say maybe I can catch him later on, which I did. And although it was a heck of a great fight, and I appreciated being in a good fight. And I think that the Canadian fans are the greatest.
Well, Archie, you certainly won.
That's expected because I was fighting the Canadian son, all Canadian soil, and I expect that. But I'm happy that everybody was satisfied with this fight. It was a great fight.
You won their hearts tonight, Archie. Was there any particular moment in the fight when you saw it was beginning to come your way?
Well, I saw it beginning to come my way in about the fourth round when I began to stiffen him up with some good enough straight jab and work him around. Then I knew that I could get a right-hand punch over, which I did.
Archie, you better get down to the dressing room and cool out a bit now. Jack, congratulations.
Thank you, Jack.
Jack Kern, the manager of Archie Moore.
How far are we going?
We are going all over the United States.
Well, I'd like to say to a lady in room 217 in Scripps Hospital in Norim Hospital in La Jolla, California. She's 90 years old, and I think that she's the sweetest, and I hope that her nurse Davis will take good care of her. And
now, 27-year-old Wallace Smith would defend his lightweight championship belt against Joe Brown. Wallace Smith would take his crown away from Jimmy Carter. So this fight would be for the lightweight championship belt. So let's take a look at this fight through the Joe Brown scrapbook right here in the Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuff series.
Soul who snaps my control. Such a funny thing, but every time you're near me, I never can behave. You give me a smile and then I'm wrapped up in your magic. There's music all around me, crazy music, music that keeps calling me so very close to you, turns me your slave. Come and do with me any little thing you want to. Anything, baby, just let me get next to you. Am I insane or do I really see heaven in your eyes? Bright as stars that shine up above you in the clear blue skies. How I worry about you, just can't live my life without you, baby, come here. Don't have no fear, oh, is there a wonder why? I'm really feeling in the mood for love. So tell me why. Stop to think about this weather, my dear. This little dream might fade away. There I go, talking out of my head again. Oh, baby, won't you come and put our two hearts together? That would make me strong and real. One, I'm not afraid if there's a cloud up above us. Go on and let it rain. I'm sure our love together will endure a hurricane. Oh, my baby, would you please let me love you and give me relief from this awful misery?
What is all this wrong? Oh, I'm loving you, my sweet. I am not afraid. Not anymore, not like before.
Don't you understand me? Now, baby, please pull yourself together. Do it soon. My soul's on fire. Come on and take me up. Be what you take me, my darling, my dear.
Oh, baby, you make me feel so good. Let me take you by the hand. Come, let us visit out there in that promised land. Maybe there we can find a good place to use a loving state of mind. I'm so tired of being without and never knowing what love's about. James, well, you can come on in, man, and you can blow now if you want to. We're through. Look at me. I'm as helpless, helpless as a kitten up a tree. Feel like I'm clinging to a cloud. I can't understand. I get misty just holding your hand.
I'm lost. That's why.
Old Bones, Joe Brown, Wallace Bud Smith. Take a look at the fight film.
Jimmy Peerless. Your commission positions attending the boys.